the anti-gang unit of the LAPD?
Well, most of our responsibilities are gathering information on the gang, so.
How many gangs do you have in Southwest?
Well, there's about at least a dozen, maybe 12 to 20 gangs that are operating in Southwest. Black gangs, Bloods, Crips, and Hispanic gangs.
You know, it tells you what the crime was, description of the people, the suspects, and basically their MO, their modus operandi, as far as what they did and how they did it. And in the back, we have a little map of how our division and where the different crimes, at what time they occurred, and you know what areas, so we know where the palm areas are at.
What are some of the cases on the sheet?
Let me see here. We got some grand theft autos, attempt murders, shootings, robberies, home invasions.
These guys right here coming up.
Yeah.
They're members of the Street Villains gang.
It's Miguel, Albert.
Come on, Mike. Why are you shy? Why are you being shy?
And later on, they'll be drinking here in the same alley.
So they seem like good kids, happy going, but
yeah, don't let that appearance fool you. They control this neighborhood here, and there's probably maybe half a dozen to a dozen there. And if need be, a couple calls on their cell phone, they'll have another dozen out.
Just like that.
Just like that.
So you knew them by name?
Pretty much, we know every single person there by name. I've arrested a few of them a couple times.
Now, what did they tell you after you arrest them for the third time, fourth time?
You know what?
318, additional on your call. Monitor the call for premise.
3 Lincoln, Sam George, 472.
3 472?
You know, you build a rapport with these people, and a lot of times they think that because they know you, you're going to give them a break. It's played with graffiti from all the surrounding gang members.
And what are some of
this right here on the right side, that's STV, that stands for Street Villains. That's the local Hispanic gang in this area.
What's the next one? The baseball glove?
Yeah, it's a baseball glove. And you'll see the letters RFC, that stands for Rolling 40s Crips Gang. So what the baseball glove represents, it is showing four fingers, and the baseball is a zero, or the four and the zero. And that represents their gang.
So even though they're, so I see another thing X'd out on the bottom, what's that?
Yeah, what that means, it's NHCG, that stands for Neighborhood Crips Gang. That's another way that they would call themselves. The H is crossed out there because it's their rival gang, the Hoovers. What they'll do is, any letters that is the first letter of the rival gang, like an H for Hoovers, will be crossed out. If you look at the top, there's another H and a K. The H is crossed out. Hoover, the H means Hoover and the K means killers.
What's your name?
China.
China. Hi, China.
Hi, baby. Don't forget about me.
No, I won't.
I'll wait for him. Never talk to his boss.
Don't be shy. Cameron's going to hurt.
I'm never shy.
That's what. Alright, ladies.
Bye.
Have a good one.
There'd be a whole bunch of shootings and a hard couple of people flying around, and I can't sleep.
Really? It bothers you to sleep?
Yes.
How many shootings do you hear?
A lot.
Really?
Yes.
Every night almost?
Yes.
What are the odds of someone growing up here not being in a gang?
Well, you're looking at that 1%. The odds are very, 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 it's tough.
He ran into a couple of street building gang members who, as he was riding his bike, asked him where he was from. And he said where he was from. And because they coincide in the same area, they basically just let it go.
Otherwise, it could have ended.
It could have ended with a fight, a shooting, or something like that. But like we stated earlier, when they coincide and they don't have a major problem with each other, they usually just stay away from each other, and that's it.
And then you'll just make sure that.
Yeah, just make sure he doesn't have any warrants, and he's not. It could be a possible murder suspect or whatever. That's the gang member that asked him where he was from.
Oh.
I see Miguel will always. Is he a style of dress?
Yeah, he always knows who's here and who's.
Yeah. And,
the way out.
Really?
Yeah, we know him. He was the one that, as he was riding his bike, asked him where he was from. And he just told her that because he said, oh, I'm Danger from Street Villains. That's Miguel's moniker, Danger.
Over here in the blue, graffiti, that's a Hispanic gang. They're called the 4-6 Street Tokers. They came here and they graffitied 4-6 Street, and there's kind of a turf war going on with some Hispanic gangs. So they came in and graffitied, and then somebody, another gang, you see the initials SCA stands for South Central Assassins. They came here and crossed out the 4-6 Tokers graffiti.
So why do they have a turf war? Is it over drugs, guns, just pride?
A lot of it is trying to claim the streets.
What's your name? Felon.
Felon?
I'll look for it, okay?
It's my role!
Do you guys see a lot of these scenes when you go out in your area? A lot of these scenes with the candles and...
Yes, it's kind of a way of people are paying their respects and memorializing their family members, their loved ones.
It's just really sad, you know, to see that an innocent bystander gets the worst end of it.
And so she's running down the sidewalk here, so we come around, and she ends up hiding underneath the car. We go to get her, she points a gun at us.
This is where we shoot at her. We pull in here, we get out, we get her. Try to go get her, she points the gun, and we shoot at her.
Was she hit?
No.
No, she was hiding underneath the car pretty good, right in the middle.
And so the injunction is like a restraining order, as it were, that they are restricted in terms of their gang activity in that specific area. And so what John talked about was the service of some of those gang members on the restraining order, as it were, that they're restrained from doing this within this year for this period of time. So, what else happened last time? That was the only major stuff. That was major enough. Yeah?
22, Cruz and Frias. Sure. 23, Avila and Lou. They're over at Communications. 24, Pack and Zabala.
Sure.
Keep in mind, you guys are on 24 today. Yeah. 31, John and Brendy. Brendy will be a little bit late. And 32, Renee and Gil.
Yes, sir.
And Jess, as usual, is going to be on 46. And I like what the lieutenant said last night, like just like we debriefed, and you know, we came back here and we discussed it again. Last night was bitching. It was a real good thing. We didn't put a lot of people in jail, but we definitely sent a message out there. And Southwest Gangs knows now that no matter where they go, we're going to follow, track them down, and do what we have to do to monitor their activities.
Do you enjoy it?
Every day.
Really?
Yeah.
It's not dangerous, though?
It's always dangerous. You know, you don't think about that. You just think about the good deeds that we do. Try to help people out. And then stuff like that.
How does the community respond when you show up?
Maybe we see different sides. We see a lot of people that have a lot of support. A lot of support for us, very happy about us. And some people that really don't like us.
Elie Seckbach reporting.